to the second episode of Life Lessons in Bon Jovi Songs, as the title has become. So I have started at the beginning at their first album. Yesterday I did, two days ago I did Runaway, and now I'm going to do Roulette, and tomorrow I'm going to do She Don't Know Me. So if you're Dutch, you can also follow stories related to this series on my Dutch blog. So that's where I kind of like, you know, get my head around the song and scribble down some thoughts and a little story. And yeah, then afterwards I come here and have probably a slightly different story, but related anyway, to the song. So I have like two outlets, one Dutch written blog and this one, the video series. So that's where we're at. We're obviously at the beginning, you know, second episode. But just to give you an idea of the frame I'm working in. So Roulette is the second song, and since the first song on the album was not written by the band, but only by Jon Bon Jovi, Roulette is actually the first band song that I'm covering here. So one of the sources that I'm using for this series is a webpage that has like all the Bon Jovi songs up until, I think, 2017-2018 ranked. So if you Google Bon Jovi songs ranked, you will find it. But you can also check the description box. And Roulette has the following description: the spiraling guitar opener motions to the dark, brooding underbelly of a sinful society addicted to crimes of passion. This is Sambora's first truly great Bon Jovi moment. So Richie Sambora, the guitarist, obviously. It was attempting, of course, to make a little story, a little life lesson about a sinful society addicted to crimes of passion. But really, I think crimes of passion, considering the circumstances, are the least of our problems. Just for those of you who do not know what crimes of passion are, what they're referring to here are not real crimes. So they're not like, like murder or anything, but just you know, sexuality and lust, and at least that's what I, as a native Dutch person, understand that the English word crimes of passion are. So it's not real crimes, and obviously, you know, with the pandemic practically making, you know, physical interaction impossible and very rare, I really think that the last thing we should worry about are crimes of passion. So I've decided to not make this story about crimes of passion, but about the roulette part. So roulette is a game that you play in the casino where you have a little ball and it can either drop on black or it can drop on red. So if you interpret it as making choices where you're not, where you have no way of knowing what the outcome will be, my interpretation is, or my lesson to you today, is that for me it was really helpful to start reasoning like what I really did not want to happen. So instead of thinking, oh, I want to have this outcome, I want to have this goal, think about, okay, what are my options here? And what is like the worst case scenario of when I do A, and what is the worst case scenario of when I do B? So I'll give you an example. Let's say, like most of us, you want to have healthy teeth, but you don't want to spend a lot of money, and you don't want to spend a lot of time. Obviously, you don't want to be in pain. You just don't want any. You want drama-free teeth. You want drama-free teeth. So if that is your goal, drama-free teeth, and then especially now that we have COVID and you can, you know, get infected at the practice, or you can You know, here in the Netherlands, you can be called by health services. Like, okay, we had a patient in that day who had the COVID virus, so you're now supposed to quarantine for 5 days or whatever. Or you can get sick because you're in the same space with other people. It becomes very difficult to see what's drama-free tea. You know, if I go in there just to have my checkup, you know, no real medical reason, and I get all this drama, you know, then I have a little drama in my life. So when you look at it from the goal perspective, I want to have drama-free teeth, it's very difficult to make a choice. Will I be going to the dentist? Will I be having my regular checkups, you know, in these years? But if you look at it from the worst case scenario, so the worst case scenario, if you go to the dentist during these times, is you're completely fine, dentally, but you have all this drama, and maybe you get sick, and you know, you have all this drama going on. So that's the worst case scenario of going to the dentist during COVID times, and you know, that's the worst possible outcome from scenario A, you're going. But the worst case scenario from B, you're not going, you're putting it off these years because you're like, well, you know, I'm just taking my chances and I don't want all that, you know, COVID drama happening. And I'll take my chances with my teeth. Then the worst case scenario is you'll get an infection, you'll lose your tooth, you'll need extra treatment for, you know, getting a prosthesis or getting an implant. So it's like when you compare those to worst case scenarios, yeah, then it's, for me at least, it's immediately obvious that I do not want the second scenario. I do not want to, you know, lose teeth, and I'll take a little drama, you know, from waiting in the waiting room or having COVID patients coming in before me. You know, it's like if you see roulette as kind of like an invitation to think about the choices that you make and choices that you do not have a clear picture of okay, you know, it could be either this way or either that way. You're not really sure what the outcome will be. There's no real, no way of telling if it will be red or black. Then think about the worst case scenarios. You know, think about if you can find a way to come up with what's the worst case scenario if I do this, and what's the worst case scenario if I do that. And if that inspires you to make a choice confidently, so not make a choice in the way that you would if you, you know, spin the ball and are in a casino. But make the choice confidently and really back yourself with an understanding of, no, I am choosing this. Not because it's completely safe, not because nothing bad will happen, but because I have thought it through, both scenarios, and I'm choosing that one, or the probability of that one happening, over the probability of the other scenario, worst case scenario, happening. And yeah, I've really... You know, every time I find myself in doubt or unsure of what to do, for me, comparing those two worst case scenarios to each other definitely always does the trick. So I hope that this helps for you too. And then I'll see you in the next video. I'll probably be doing it like in 2 days, I think. Maybe tomorrow, if it's a good day, I don't know. And I'll see you there. And I also intend to pick up my business channel if you are interested in that, where I'm teaching you how to rock your business. Then find the link below in the description box, and I'm going to kind of like, you know, do something different there, try out something new, and I would be excited to see you there as well. So, either at Rock Your Business or here on this channel. See you next time. Bye.